And we have breaking news coming in at top of 6 p.m. this evening. Scathing attacks are being made at Parambir Singh and Sachin Waze from all sides who are in soup over extortion cases. For more on this, let me go across to my colleague Shravan joining us on this broadcast. Yes, Shravan, over to you.
Well, in fact, Richard, this entire secret meeting that was essentially being touted as, remember, Parambir Singh, the DG rank officer, who is also an accused in multiple cases, had a meeting, allegedly, when the Chandiwal Commission was actually taking place with none other than another accused. Now, Julia Ribeiro, one of the most respected IPS officers from Maharashtra, has basically reacted to this, and I quote, in fact, this is the quote that he has given to my colleague Niranjan, with whom he spoke a short while ago. And remember, this comes at a time when IPS officer Julia Ribeiro, the former Mumbai police commissioner, has essentially said that these are some very scathing allegations that have been leveled, where he says the number of IAS and IPS officers who have essentially seen this are absolutely flummoxed. Damocles sword that is basically hanging over his head, and that is the reason why such reactions are also now coming in. Now, what we are being told is that politicians essentially have been saddled the city with a police that doesn't have public interest in mind. That's one important point that has been made by Julia Ribeiro. He also goes on to say, first time that a police official of such high rank has been dubbed as an absconder. Parambir has brought great shame to a service that was first port of call. Number of IAS and IPS officers falling prey to temptation of getting rich is just rising. Damocles sword of confiscation of his properties are hanging over Parambir's head. Remember, he's written an elaborate editorial, and this article has been written for the Indian Express. And not just that, he's also spoken to Republic TV, where he says that it is shameful when such a meeting of this nature is actually taking place between two officers who have now been under the scanner. What has really transpired thereafter? There is a denial that has basically come in from Parambir's side, essentially saying that this is nothing but a media hype that has been done. He's also taken the name of certain publications, saying that it is absolutely untrue to call it a secret meeting that has taken place. Let me bring in my colleague Alisha, who's been closely tracking all the developments at the Chandiwal Commission. Alisha, if I can bring you in, put the facts on record. What really happened on the very day when there were reports essentially suggesting that there was a meeting that actually took place? And how did the meeting take place? At the end of the day, you've had the Maharashtra Home Minister ordering an inquiry into this entire matter. Mumbai Police Commissioner Hemant Nagrale looking into this entire report. A default report has already been prepared after questioning the additional one of the senior officers, and thereafter we are given to understand that the Navi Mumbai police has also been roped in. What more details are you picking up?
Well, Shravan, talking about the meeting which commenced between Parambir Singh and Sachin Waze, let me put things into perspective. On Monday, when Parambir Singh appeared before the Chandiwal Commission, and the time Chandiwal Commission cancelled his bailable warrant, right after that, Parambir Singh left the chamber of the Chandiwal Commission, and to the right side, he entered to a room, followed by Sachin Waze. Importantly, what I noticed there, and there were other media people who has already noticed, that there were no lawyers and the police authorities who entered that room, but only Parambir Singh and Sachin Waze was inside the closed door meeting, which held for around 1 hour. And this objection was raised by Anil Deshmukh, lawyer, before the commission, stating that the meeting between Parambir Singh and Sachin Waze, which went for around 1 hour, can really influence the evidence, and this can influence the case. Importantly, the Chandiwal Commission has also taken a note, and right after that, when it comes to the media report, importantly, Mumbai police also has come there. We saw additional CP Dilip Sawant, who entered the Chandiwal Commission and already taken the statement of an escort in charge, the escort party in charge, who brought Sachin Waze from Taloja jail to Chandiwal Commission. Not only this, but Mumbai police has already sent the default report to the Navi Mumbai Commissioner of Police. As we know that Sachin Waze was under the judicial custody, and the Taloja jail, which comes under Navi Mumbai jurisdiction. So the default report report has already been sent by the Mumbai Police to the Navi Mumbai Commissioner of Police, and now the Navi Mumbai Police Commissioner will take action accordingly against the concerned person looking after their roles and liability. But Maharashtra government has also, while speaking to the media, where Maharashtra Home Minister Dilip Valse Patil has clearly stated that Sachin Vaze, who is an accused and under the judicial custody, how can a meeting can commence between when there was no permission? And today, when Sachin Vaze and Anil Deshmukh appeared before the Chandival Commission, Parambir Singh lawyers has filed a process before the Chandival Commission stating there was a report of a secret meeting which was published by the whether it is print media or the electronic media. But the commission has already taken a note of it, and importantly, while talking about the point number 7, which also mentioned that on 30th, that is yesterday, Anil Deshmukh and Sachin Vaze had a meeting. This also raises a question where Anil Deshmukh advocate Anita Castellino, she has also raised the objection that there was no meeting held between and which was agreed by the Chandival Commission. After that, the persuasion given by the Parambir Singh lawyer, they have withdrawn it. So we can see how Parambir Singh has been trying very hard before the Chandival Commission to say that there was no secret meeting. But when Chandival Commission has already taken objection and already said there was no personal meeting held between Anil Deshmukh, and they are wrongly pointed out, whether the commission lawyer has also before the commission has stated the media has the right to report, and what has happened is exactly what was mentioned by the commission itself, and commission hasn't given the permission to Sachin Vaze to speak to any either person. So importantly, now the Maharashtra government has already ordered for an inquiry, where Mumbai police has already submitted, has given their default report to the Navi Mumbai Police Commissioner. Now we have to wait and watch what Navi Mumbai Police Commissioner look into it, because the report has already been submitted, and they have been recording the statement. They will look after the escort party in charge, who was escort party in charge, and the other person who made this happen, who made this comment, the meeting which was commenced on Monday between Parambir Singh and Sachin Vaze.
Well, thank you very much, Alicia. I'll request you to stay on. Let me also bring in our legal editor joining us on this broadcast. Rhythm, just put this into perspective. What really transpired in the Chandival Commission? It is undoubtedly a big embarrassment for Parambir Singh, because at the end of the day, there is no denial as far as this particular meeting is concerned, and the affidavit finally had to be withdrawn.
Absolutely. So let's tell our viewers, Shravan, Alisha's been tracking this very closely since the past few weeks, and especially in the past 2 days, where she's been stationed at the Chandival Commission. And what we are coming to know is, and this is very interesting, today morning, there was an affidavit that was filed by Parambir and his lawyers before the Chandival Commission. That affidavit tried to say that there are certain media reports that are coming out in which there are great details that are being spoken about this Parambir-Vaze meeting. However, when this particular affidavit came before the commission, there was a huge chaos, because Parambir's lawyers filed this, and then Parambir's lawyers were told that there has to be a point 7 that has to be removed, because point 7 had alleged that not only are these media reports incorrect, but also that Deshmukh and Vaze had also met. This was vociferously heard by Deshmukh's lawyer, and it was stated that this was not true. The commission, Justice Chandival said, I agree, it didn't happen. And then Parambir's lawyers were forced to withdraw the process or the affidavit, however you look at it. What does this really mean? Today morning, therefore, if we try and understand the hints and the signs that are coming forward, there was an attempt that was made by Parambir's team and Parambir to ensure that the secret meeting that has been highlighted in the entire media, including in the other newspapers and articles that we are giving courtesy to today, have clearly shown that he tried to violate the kind of the order, the interim protection that was granted to him and enjoyed by him from the topmost court of the country. Now, what this translates into is, when that attempt didn't work out, to scuttle out of it before the Justice Chandival Commission, his lawyers withdrew this particular process. The process was very clear. It's a 2-page affidavit that was filed. And what I want to actually go across to is what the process also said, because that clearly highlights what he was trying to do. In fact, his lawyers came before the court and said only courtesies were actually spoken between Vaze and Parambir. And then it goes on to say that after that, they say that this was also done between Deshmukh and Vazir, which Deshmukh's lawyers denied. But this particular secret meeting held between Parambir and Sachin Vazir, they do not deny. So the first thing in this affidavit that or this pursuit that caught our attention is there was no denial from Parambir of the meeting that happened with Sachin Vazir. They say that the door was unlocked, both were seated and waiting. And they, he also says there were only plenaries and common courtesies exchanged. But the big point here, once it was withdrawn only because the court pointed out that there was also fabrication where Parambir's lawyers had said Deshmukh went Vazir, so what's the big deal about this? Now, why are we talking about it? The reason for this is simple. And before I go across to Alisha once again, the reason is that there is a disgraced cop who is now in jail in Taloja, who was brought for cross-examination to the Chandiwal Commission on Monday. On that very day, a high and mighty cop who tries to dictate his term several times over had moved to the Supreme Court after being a proclaimed offender and missing since 229 days. Ironically, one has five FIRs against him, another is in for a murder charge, and yet they both had the time to exchange these courtesies, plenaries as they call, but as a lot of sources are telling us that in the adjoining room of the Chandiwal Commission, there was this one-hour meeting. Alisha, I just want to understand, when you were inside the Chandiwal Commission today and you saw the entire proceedings before you, what was the body language of Parambir's lawyers? Because they are trying to say that articles are coming out on a secret meeting that are incorrect, whereas they themselves gave wrong facts before the commission when they said Deshmukh met Vazir.
Well, in fact, Ritha, thank you for putting this into perspective. We'll continue with our coverage, looking closely into what's really happening at the Chandiwal Commission, and more trouble certainly brewing for Parambir Singh as a departmental inquiry has been ordered by the Maharashtra government based on a report that has been filed by the Maharashtra Chief Secretary. We'll be closely tracking all the developments. Thank you very much, Ritha, as well as Alisha, for getting us all the latest updates.